President Trump holds out hope he can reach a nuclear deal with North Korea. The president's optimism comes despite more threatening missile tests and a break in diplomacy. And North Korea isn't the only country pushing back against the president. President Trump sent a series of tweets today defending his outreach to North Korea. He writes, "Chairman Kim Jong-un will do the right thing because he is far too smart not to, and he does not want to disappoint his friend, President Trump." North Korea raised alarm when it launched another round of short-range missiles. But President Trump adds, "These missile tests are not a violation of our signed Singapore agreement, nor was there discussion of short-range missiles when we shook hands." North Korea had a chance today to meet with diplomats from the U.S., Japan, and South Korea on the sidelines of an Asian security conference in Bangkok. But North Korea was a no-show. Speaking to conservatives in Georgia, Vice President Mike Pence stands behind the president's foreign policies.
I mean, how great is it to have a president who's standing up for America on the world stage instead of apologizing for America to the world?
President Trump also rattled stock markets when he announced more tariffs on China. He said he's going to keep taxing the country until they agree to a trade deal.
They want to wait till they get, they're praying. They would like to see a new president in a year and a half so they could continue to rip off the United States like they've been doing for the last 25 years.
At a rally last night in Cincinnati, President Trump also made headlines when he said America is on the verge of new breakthroughs in science and medicine. But this claim is leading to more questions.
There's never been anything like it. We will be ending the AIDS epidemic shortly in America and curing childhood cancer very shortly.